So you want to win an NCAA championship. Some think it's easy, and on paper, maybe it is. Just win the next six games in a row, and you've reached your goal. But as Dickie V is going to tell you, these are the toughest six games to play. And you'll see that in today's game between the New Mexico State Aggies and the Illinois Fighting Illini.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Fighting Illini should have a cakewalk tonight, Dick. What are the keys for them, you think?
Hey, the keys for them should be straightforward tonight. First of all, play it your style. Don't get roped into doing things that you normally don't do. You must be in control. Second, reward your big man. Give him the ball down low. Get him into the game. Let him be part of the offense. Lastly, get your man on your hip after the shot. Block out and get after those boards.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. They go into the low block.
Very soft defensively. No pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
The Aggies go to the line for the first time in this game. Misses the first shot. Need to make that. Goes and gets it.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
Working it around the perimeter. On the dribble, gives it up. Got the high pick. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
He steps up to the line. Misses his first shot. Rims off. They take it off the defensive glass.
Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court.
He shoots from outside. Way off target. The point guard with the ball. Down inside. For the bucket. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. This is what you're supposed to do down low. Go up strong.
I tell you, that was great post play. Clinic 101 on how to explode to the goal.
He keeps his dribble as they reset. Now trying to feed the low block. Kicks it out.
Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. Dump it inside.
He bombs from outside. Off the rim and no good. Trying to feed the low block. Dickie's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you. He's just not giving the effort on defense.
He's not putting up a good fight at all. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
This place will go senseless, Dick, if they can get a stop. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Tremendous pressure. Just enough to force the steal.
He's got
to
pass those off, Dick.
He doesn't trust his teammates, Brad.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're still waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
Thanks, Aaron.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
They're working around the arc. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Buried it. He shoots from downtown. Way off target. Ball handler's in trouble. Finney
is eager and excited to compete. Well, he's had some success and he feels good. This kid's on an emotional high right now.
I don't even know if you and I can find a seat in this place, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, you get the home court advantage when you got a crowd like this. By the way, you and I have the best seat in the house.
First shot, no good. Hits the second.
Let's see if they go two for one here, Brad. High post screen. So effective, that screen.
He's not letting the game come to him at all.
Yeah, Brad, he's trying too hard to build a one-man show. He's taking the game away from his other teammates. Come on, man, get with the team. Get in the flow.
Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Makes the shot.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
The shooting guard receives the ball. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
If he keeps this up, he may collapse. His teammates must pick it up.
The Fighting Illini are ahead by two. This one's been a nail-biter so far, Dick. What play do you think set the tone in the first half, in your opinion?
In my opinion, Mr. Nessler, this trifecta is what set the tone for the offense in the first half. It represents the deep arsenal of threats this team has to offer.
And now let's get ready for the start of the second half. Illinois is getting a lot of rebounds, Dick, in that first half.
Hey, Brad, these boys gave a monstrous performance on the board. They were relentless in retrieving the rock.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us. Erin?
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Erin. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal them off.
And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
I think, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
The point guard gets the pass. Goes up for two. In and out.
Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
Diggs receives the ball. Number 15, pump fakes. Here's the offensive drop step on a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
He lets it go. Knocks it down. Dumps it in. Jumped in front to take it away. He wants a three. Poor decision there to shoot that three.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
Gave it up. Unloads. Good. The power forward takes the pass. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Now looking to move it down court in a hurry. Jumps into the defender. He gets the board.
Up and inside.
Cross handles the pass. Fake. He up fakes.
Run him right at the screen again. What did I say?
For the bucket. And off the mark.
That's spacing.
Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, down here on the sidelines, there is such intensity from both benches. Both coaches are emphasizing shot selection and defensive stops. So important here in the second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Routine. New Mexico State are putting together a pretty good run here.
Execution's been the key, baby.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
That's just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
Unloads a three. He gets the shot to fall. That bucket cuts the lead to one.
I told you there was a lot of time, Brad.
There's the pick. There's the roll. They don't seem to be getting any decent shot opportunities, Dick.
Because they're looking in the wrong places, Brad.
Picked off. And a momentary look from three-point land. Ware handles the feed. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Timeout on the court, so let's go courtside. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, with limited time remaining, the coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
I think she's right about that, Richie. We might see a little different look this time, Dick.
You never know what's coming, Brad.
It's a three-point deficit.
And that can change in a matter of seconds, baby. Hold on.
The power forward gets the ball. The ball goes out of bounds. Oh, and you talk about a happy group of fans. Listen to this crowd.
Oh, there's all kinds of people standing and cheering and going wacky. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Looking for a good shot. He shoots from downtown. Not a wise decision to take that shot there.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in close games.
Foul, and that stops the clock again.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ballgame. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And the clock stopped with a foul. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
Oh, and look at the crowd, and look at the reaction.
I tell you, the whole fans are going crazy. There's jubilation.
And yet another foul. stops the clock again.
I like it when the team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
Second shot is good.
They can make it very interesting with a score here.
Back to the live action we go. It's a five-point ball game.
That's not a lot of points to be down with this much time, Brad.
He fouled him. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Diggs goes to the line for the first time. No doubt. Gets the second shot. Rims out.
Better foul quick.
And here's a look at the foul situation.
Well, Brad, fouling and knowing when to foul is an important part of the game. If you have fouls to give, sometimes it's better to commit one rather than giving up an easy basket.
Foul shot, no good. Get ready to bounce back into action here. The ball goes out of play. From downtown, he nails the shot. Switch things around here for the moment, Dick?
I don't think so, but we'll wait and see, Brad.
Can these boys handle overtime, Dick?
Hey, can they handle it? They live for it, baby. With such a well-played game, it's only fitting. The score is all not enough, and that these teams are going into overtime.
Dick, the only thing I don't like about this is somebody's got to lose this. When you get to the NCAA tournament, all of a sudden you're in overtime. Five more minutes or more, it can't get much more exciting than this.
I tell you, we got two evenly matched clubs that have really responded. The PTPers are playing well, the stars, the coaches have their teams prepared, and it's all going to get down, I believe, to the free throw line at the end of this game.
Got a nice screen. He uses the shot fake with a jump hook. Rims out. The center takes the feed. Tries to get the D to bite. He strips him clean. Goes for the steal down low, and he didn't get it.
I think he took a chance, and he lost, baby. Up it inside.
On the dribble, gives it up. The small forward gets the pass. For the bucket. Two with a lay-in. We get another look.
This defender is resilient. Still applying pressure.
the rim and no good. Gets the rejection. He pump fakes. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Grant handles the pass. He pump fakes. Steals the pass. The power forward receives the pass. The student body has got it going on. They look to be filled with rage and eager for a win.
Oh, yes, the student body, always full of comedy and excitement.
In the paint. Good job defensively. They just won't give many openings.
Pressuring the basketball.
The small forward takes the pass. He goes up strong, and that's going to be an offensive foul.
Oh, great call by the official. He beat him to the spot. That's essential defensively.
Spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
For two, New Mexico State is showing a bit of a run here.
Things are going their way right now.
Gave it up. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. For the deuce, that's good. Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
The replay's not even enough for this one.
They cut the lead to two.
Hold on to your seat, Mr. Nestler.
Out of play. Oh, and this packed house is showing their appreciation for their team.
Well, there's euphoria out there. They're really excited. They're going bananas.
Goes up for two, and he missed. This one might go down to the final buzzer.
I call these ones knee knockers, Brad. Close games that can easily go down to the final second.
Perimeter. He shoots from the angle. Buried it. Timeout on the floor. Aaron Andrews, what do you got for us, EA?
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Change might be in order, don't you think, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if they changed things up a little bit, Brad.
The small forward gets the ball. Takes away the pass. Pushes it up.
Hey, one basket, Brad. If they can get some points here, the crowd will be extremely happy.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Basket falls despite the contact. Maybe some game plan changes, Dick?
You never know what's coming, Brad.
And we're back to a two-point game. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid is responding in a positive way. Up and inside.
Cross court. Jumped in front to take it away. Shot clock is dead. They work it around the perimeter. On the dribble, gives it up. Launches away. Gets it to go. Just about ready for play to resume. They'd like to get it inside with a low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
It's always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Dick.
Well, you got to think, the shooters might be the most effective, Brad.
All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on, one team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
New Mexico State played exactly the type of game they need to get